Magazine Top Live. I'm Kimberly Chapman, Publisher.
And I'm Sammy Hayes, Editor-in-Chief of She Magazine.
And we have absolutely just been enjoying our time here in New York for Fashion Week.
Yeah!
And we've been filming here at Short Spoonbread.
Yeah.
Yes, oh my gosh, and the food has been
Oh, the food is marvelous. I had the cheese just a second ago, so we had another cake. I'm looking at that cut on that cake and I'm saying, my God, get it out of my face.
Everyone, this is the beautiful Norma Darden.
Yes, here I am.
That's it, right?
I'm Norma Jean Darden from Spoonbread, and all those cakes are made by my little sister, Carol Darden.
Oh, really?
Everything here is homemade, farm to table.
Right. So no canned. No canned food.
Oh, no.
I like that.
That doesn't make sense, does
it? No.
And you can clearly taste the farm right to the table.
Greens are washed three times, the string beans, the corn, shucked, and everything here. Yes.
Oh, my gosh, I got to get corn. I didn't get corn.
Oh, we have corn on the cob.
Oh, my gosh, I got to get
corn. And corn off the cob.
Okay. I got to get some corn
and tomatoes.
Oh, my gosh, really? The table we eat, my mom, my grandmother used to call it
succotash.
Oh,
right.
So you got
succotash.
I just don't have the
butter beans. Oh. Wow. You got all that soul food in your blood.
Yeah.
And you're in New York, though.
Well, that's from Wilson, North Carolina.
You from Wilson, North Carolina?
That's where my family was from.
Oh, I live in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Very familiar with Wilson.
Big
time. Whoa.
So you were a model also.
I was. I was one of the first side models. We went to Paris and we brought New York style to Paris and opened up a market for American sportswear.
Oh my God.
In Europe. Before then, everything was Europe to New York. Uh-huh. But after we went to Versailles, it really opened up markets for the American designers in Europe.
Oh my God.
So we've been honored all year long.
Oh my goodness.
Yes.
So have you been a part of this New York Fashion Week this week?
No, this week I had catering parties for Columbia, which came back, which are neighbors, so I didn't get to participate very much, but usually I go to B. Michael's show,
yeah.
I try and support him, and of course my dear friend at Lafayette was up there too. So, but this year I wasn't able to because the food took me away from it, and I had a wedding. And our cookbook is coming back.
Oh my gosh, coming back out.
Yes.
So how long was it not in print?
About 3 years.
Okay.
And so we're so happy that Amazon has brought it back so people can now get Spoonbread and strawberry wine online.
Oh my gosh.
Spoonbread
and strawberry wine. That is awesome. So you're the author.
We and my sister, Carol, wrote a book. We were... while I was modeling, the editor at Vogue magazine, I was there for a shooting, and she asked me what was my ethnic origin. And I told her that my grandfather had been born a slave, and that fascinated her. So she called up and told me, you must have a wonderful cookbook. We were thinking about cookbook, but it changed the whole direction of our lives. Because we did have a cookbook.
Oh, wow.
We had the wonderful homemade recipes that our grandmothers on both sides had made.
Mm-hmm.
And what we didn't know was that we also had pictures of them.
Oh, that's awesome.
And since most of them had died before we were even born, going back and collecting the pictures gave us a new sense of family.
Mm-hmm.
And that's
history.
What you see on these walls.
That's
what my grandparents looked back in the day, and on my mother's side, they migrated from Canton, Alabama, to Kentucky, and then on to Ohio.
Oh, wow.
And so we had found pictures of their roots, and then you have my parents' honeymoon in Cuba over here, and our grandmother and grandfather over here on their wedding day in 1903. So this restaurant has pictures of my whole life.
Oh, that's awesome. So how did you get to New York from Ohio? Like, what brought
you here? Well, my mother and the Ku Klux Klan brought us here.
Because
my father was practicing medicine in Alabama,
mm-hmm.
and the Klan objected to him being in the town, and they burned a cross on his brother's property. And my brother said, you know, I think this town is went back to North Carolina every summer.
Wow.
They give us a little shoebox with our fried chicken and our deviled eggs and lifesavers and little pops. And they put us on the train with our name in Wilson, North Carolina. And they give us to the people on the train.
Mm-hmm.
And we would get there the next morning. And we would try not to eat all our food at once.
So much history inside of this group of them, inside of your hands.
Oh, definitely that.
Wow. And that's, you know, I think that it's a wonderful thing. One of the things that I saw that when I was at BBY's play, that it's important for us to preserve our history.
Yes.
And to tell our story. And when you just told your grandparents, your parents in this room, you preserve your history.
Absolutely. And we want everybody to do the same. Because now, you know, you have your cameras, you have your recordings, and, you know, time gets by and the old people don't get to tell their stories if you don't grab them and sit them down. So we tell all young people, go out there and interview your grandparents, your aunts, everybody, get their story. Because once they're gone, you're going to say, well, I wonder what it was like when they were young. And you'll never get an answer. So do it now.
Right.
Yes.
So when a person comes into Spoonbread, you're in a great location. What do you want your customer to experience?
Down home Southern comfort. Mm-hmm. Yes, we want them to be in a cozy setting and to have warm attendance and to enjoy themselves.
Yeah,
right.
We have absolutely enjoyed this food. It's been amazing.
Well, thank you.
Yes. And so when did you get your love of cooking?
Well, I guess when I was a model, I couldn't eat. I had to be a size 8.
Well, that would make that happen.
Yes. So I don't mind that I've blossomed up. Because I have to taste it first.
There you go.
Yes. But I think I got a real appreciation for food when I was modeling in Italy. That was some of the best food I have ever had. I enjoyed it more than the French, actually, and certainly more than when I was in London.
Well, I was trying to remember the food. It was good.
In Paris, in France.
Yeah.
And I'm really, no, Paris, nah. But I haven't been to Italy yet. My husband and my son have, and they say it's awesome.
Good.
So we'll have to go to Italy.
And the funny thing is, it's better than the Italian food here. I think there's something about the soil and the water there. But there were models that went over there and never came back.
and
went to size 14s. Yes, it was just addictive.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
Yes.
Good food.
So now, do you have children?
No
children.
I have a nephew who was our chef here and now opened up the restaurant in Brooklyn.
Okay, so is it Spoonbread too?
No.
Okay.
He's ventured into Mediterranean food.
Oh, wow.
Yes, at a place called Calvin Clover.
Calvin Clover?
Yes.
Oh, my God. How did you come up with that name?
I have no idea. Yes.
Gosh, so now you can get the cookbook on
Amazon,
and it is called Spoonbread and Strawberry Wine. So make sure you go to Amazon and pick your cookbook up that was written by Miss Norma.
And Carol.
Of course. So now, where's your sister? Is she here in this area?
Oh, yeah, she's the baker. She does all the cornbreads, the pies, the cobblers, the banana pudding.
That's what I got to taste, the cobbler, you know.
Harlem is across the street.
Okay.
Yeah. So kind of, sort of in Harlem.
Yes.
So we're kind kind of started in Harlem and kind of started over there.
West Side.
West Side.
Martin Luther.
Yes.
Got
it.
Gosh.
Wow.
Nice. Oh, nice. Thank you so much for hosting us and allowing us to come in and film in your restaurant.
My pleasure.
It's been very good.
I just adore having you.
Thank you. We'll definitely be back.
The woman entrepreneur.
Yes.
Yes. Dee. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you again to 108 Praise, My MBN, Channel 4 at CBN. And again, thank you so much for your continued support. And we have definitely had a great time.
Oh, my God. We have. We're going to eat some more, enjoy some more, shop, and see some more fashion.
Great.
Have a great day.